Dear friends, I am Parvinder from West Highlander and I welcome you all in yet another informative session about study in Canada. In today's video, I would be speaking about one of the common grounds of refusal for Canada student visa and the three important points the students must take care of in order to increase the chances of their student visa. So friends, keep watching for complete information. One of the common reasons for refusal of Canada student visa application is that the case officer is not satisfied that you will leave Canada at the end of your stay. So your purpose of visit to Canada is to study, and your student visa application must reflect the circumstances which prove that you are a genuine student whose only intention to visit Canada is to study. The students must take care of three things to prove this. The first one is study progression. The second one is English language ability, and the third one is the financial ability. Study progression plays a very important role in the success of your student visa application. The course the student wishes to do in Canada must be a clear-cut reflection of the past studies and any work experience the student may hold. If you choose a course which does not show a relevancy, it may result in refusal of your application. To quote an example, suppose the student, he has done his BCom over here, and after that he has got a few years of work experience, and then he wishes to go for a course in a business, a PG diploma in business or an MBA program. Now this combination of your past experience, your qualification here in your home country, and the course you wish to do in Canada shows a clear progression of your study, and this would have a positive impact on your application. Another example I would like to quote here is of a student who has got a teaching degree over here. He has spent some time in teaching in a school over here and now wishes to pursue a business diploma. In this case, the student would strongly need to justify his choice of course, because this does not show a regular progression or logical study progression. So this may have a negative impact on the application if it is not justified properly. The second point the students need to take care is of the English language ability. English is one of the official languages of Canada, and to successfully do a course in Canada, the student must have a level of English which shows that he can be successful in pursuing the course. This can be in the form of an IELTS band score or an equivalent PT or a TOEFL score or other English test which the Canadian embassy accepts. If you do not fulfill the English language course requirement of the program you wish to do in Canada, this may have a negative impact on the application. So it's highly recommended that the students, they have the level of English which is required to successfully complete a course in Canada. The third point which the students must take care is the financial ability. The students, they are planning to spend a huge amount of money for their further studies in Canada, and they must have enough financial resources to pay their tuition fee and support their cost of living. For this, the students need to provide evidence in the form of bank statements or any other liquid assets they may have. If it's a STS application, the students, they need to provide evidence of payment of first year of tuition fee and a GIC certificate of Canadian dollars 10,000. But if the application falls under non-STS category, students must take care that they must show the amount that they have to cover their cost and tuition in Canada for the full duration of the course. Friends, I hope you find this information useful. For any query you may have about your study in Canada application, please contact West Highlander. We have highly experienced and expert counselors who can guide you throughout your application process. Thank you.